Hello, this is Mark from tradeinform.com and welcome to this video on a simple way to use Excel to set up a Monte Carlo test. In this video, I'll be using the example of a trading strategy to show you how we can set up a Monte Carlo simulation using Excel formulas and a VBA macro. Please remember, if you do like this video, to hit the like button and also subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. Now, before we can do a Monte Carlo simulation, we need to have some background data. And what I'm going to use is the trades, which is outputted from a backtest that I've done of a trading strategy. And if I scroll across here, you can see that I'm actually using a backtest spreadsheet. This is a trade-informed backtest model that can be used to test all sorts of different trading strategies, different indicators, and different markets and time frames. And if you want more information about trade-informed backtest models, there is a link on the screen at the moment. Okay, so as I was saying, I'm using this column. This is our list of trades, and I'm going to reorder them. The purpose for this is to work out the worst case scenario, and I'm going to be looking at the maximum drawdown as a proxy for our worst case scenario here. Now, to begin with, what I'm going to do is I am going to order the original trades using a number. Now, just copied this number down to all the rows below, and then I am going to introduce an Excel function that generates a random number. And again, copy this down. Now, Monte Carlo methods are built on randomization, and so this is how we're going to use randomization in this example. And the next thing that I want to do is to translate this random number into a version of these numbers here. And I'm going to do that using the rank formula. And what this is doing is basically ranking each of these numbers, random numbers, in the order that they appear in the whole sequence. And I'm going to use the dollar symbols to make this a fixed range. Okay, I'm going to double click this down. And now what we have here is a randomized trade order, which is exactly the same as this number, these numbers here, but in a different order. So it's nice to have these numbers in a different order, but what we want to do is to have the trades over here from column CA. And the way I'm going to do that is to use my favorite compound function in Excel, which is index match. Whenever we're using index match, we always put at the very start, we put the range that we want to output. And in this case, this is the range of trades. Then I'm going to put a comma in here and I'm going to put the match part of the function. And what I want to match is this new random trade order that we've generated with the original trade order. Once again, I'm going to use the dollar symbol to make this a fixed reference. And finally, I want to make it an exact match. Again, I'm going to copy this down. And now what I have is these trades moved over here, except in a random order. So we're going to turn this into a capital, our ongoing capital, by using the sum function, which is the current value plus all the previous values, starting with a notional $100,000. And we can see that we have now populated this chart here. And also, every time I make a keystroke, I will change the order of the trades. And you may have seen this number over here changing. So what we've got here is this particular scenario, the maximum drawdown for that particular scenario. Now we can compare and contrast it with the maximum drawdown of my original strategy. I should say this is the drawdown function I am using, which is calculating 1 minus the current value divided by the maximum of all the previous values. So what we have here already, as I said, this is a simple way. What we have here already is a simple manual Monte Carlo simulator. And I could sit here and I could make 100 keystrokes and I will have 100 different maximum drawdowns appear in this cell. So we could stop here, but I want to show you how we can automate this process. And we do that using Visual Basic or VBA for Excel. And I've already set up the code for the VBA and there's a couple of simple inputs here. Firstly, I'm going to tell it to do 10 iterations. So go through 10 different random scenarios and tell me what the worst drawdown of each of those is. And I've got a button here which I can click, which will test my macro. And we can see that our strategy drawdown, 16.9%. What we would generally expect here is that our Monte Carlo simulation has come up with a drawdown which is slightly worse. I can click that again and we can find one that is actually slightly better. I can click that again and again. What I would generally expect to be the case, it's slightly worse. Now I can set this to 20 or 50 or 1,000 or as many iterations as you like. So I put in some code for this macro here and I can show you it here. Now this is a simple way and I've got some pretty simple code here. Now you can simply copy it from the screen if you like, but I'll go over how I've done it. So I'm using here a simple counting system. And the first of these of interest is here, which is the number of iterations, which must correspond to this cell here. Bring it back again. And next thing that I want to do is always clear the value of this cell. Before we do anything else, let's get rid of our old values and start afresh. So again, this range here must always correspond with this cell here. We use a loop, which we use in all sorts of programming, every sort of programming really, and we're going to do until our start is equal to our number of iterations. So until we've done 10 iterations. What we're simply going to do is copy over each scenario at a time, and we're going to work out what I'm calling here the new DD, which stands for the new drawdown. And we're going to then use a if statement, an if statement to check whether this particular scenario has a worse drawdown than all the other scenarios that we have tested. And if it does, then it gets entered in this cell here, which you can see here is range CO196. So if we happen to move this particular cell, all we need to do is match up this cell with the new value. It's going to loop and then the end of the macro. So this is a nice, simple macro. Please remember that you can also get this spreadsheet with the Monte Carlo simulator in it, and it is available in the Trade Informed shop, and there is a link on the screen if you want to check that out. So I hope you have enjoyed this video on Monte Carlo simulations. Please remember to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. Also hit the like button and comment below. If you would like to know more about trading the financial market, in particular backtesting using Excel, please go to www.tradeinformed.com.